Yes, so welcome again to daylighting. Starting with daylighting, the name itself indicates that lighting that is available during daytime. So the source of light is again sunlight. Okay, so the natural source of daylighting is sunlight. So we try to use this particular lighting that is available in abundant for especially for tropical countries like India. Okay. Where most of the things buildings they try to use daylighting. So we try to understand how it is used and what should be the quality of light. Now we always say that when we get light inside the building, it also brings in heat. Okay. So starting with the radiation spectrum. So light is classified into this spectrum based on its wavelength. Okay, if it is a shorter wavelength, it is considered as ultraviolet rays. Yes, and if it is of very higher wavelength, then it is considered as infrared. Okay, so this is I think on the top what you can see is the largest spectrum of X-rays, cosmic rays. Okay, radar, very high frequency or the radio frequency. Okay. So, what we study is mainly the visible light of this particular wavelength from 800 nanometer to 400 nanometer. So, based on the different wavelength, again, colors are classified. There is a classification of colors. So, usually at the higher end, it is red. The wavelength of higher these things, light with higher wavelength is usually red. And light with very less wavelength is again blue, green, or violet. Okay. This is not the only reason that we classify colors as cool colors or warm colors. Okay, so the classification is also done based on the feeling that we get by looking at those colors. Okay. It is not just what kind of light it is emitting or what kind of light it is getting reflected. Okay. It is also what influence it does on, let's say, human psychology. Okay, so that is why blue green is considered as cool colors, whereas yellow is also considered as warm color. Okay, yellow, orange, or red is also considered as warm colors. It is not, I'm just saying this, but it is not basically this is the only criteria for colors to be classified as red color, warm colors, or cool colors. Okay. So we'll be dealing with mainly the visible light that is having this wavelength of 800 to 400 nanometers. Okay. So transmission is when some material is exposed to light, it allow light to pass through it. So that is nothing but again transmission. Okay. Opaque is when it blocks the passage of light. Okay. It is considered as opaque. So you can say opaque is transmission, opposite of transmission. Yes. So now, in between these two, opaque and transparent, there is one more which is called as translucent. Okay, this is applied to a material which transmit only one part of incident light. Yes, so we use it for different purposes where we need light but we don't need the view. Okay, so I think in design also you must be considering a lot of places where you need light but you don't want the view. Okay. Sometimes it is there is a partial so there is again different types of translucent materials based on the amount of transparency it offers. Okay, so there might be 50% or 80%, 70%. So there are different again you can say classification of the material which can be used. Okay. Some places like very private areas maybe you don't need you need at least like let's say 50% of or higher percentage of light to enter, or you don't want any kind of view from that particular place. Like maybe toilet sometimes, yes, you use for skylights, yes. So there are various places where we try to use this translucent or transparent materials. Okay, and so basically they scatter or diffuse light in all the in other directions. Okay, so important you can say properties of the object or materials can be described as either reflectance, absorbance, or transmittance when we study in terms of let's say daylighting or in terms of lighting on any particular object. So either it is reflected, either it is absorbed, or either it is transmitted. Okay. And in all cases, the summation of reflectance and absorbance and transmittance is 1. That is, let's say 100% of light is falling on a particular object. Maybe 30% is reflected, 30% is absorbed. Then actually 40% is transmitted. Okay. Or if it is a very opaque object, then transmittance is 0. And thus reflectance and absorption is together considered as 100%. Okay. So let's say if we consider as an object, which is maybe a blackboard or these things where the transmittance is not possible, but again, it is either absorbed, light is either absorbed by that material or it is reflected. Okay. So mirror, if you consider mirror, then the light is almost, let's say 100% it is reflected, almost 100%. So there might be some light which is absorbed again. So you can say 99% or 98% it is reflected, maybe 1 or 2%, or even less than that is absorbed. But if you consider very solid and opaque objects, so they don't allow any kind of transmittance. Usually it is either reflected or absorbed. Now this reflectance is also having different types. Okay, so it is again, it is reflected in a particular angle. If it is a very smooth surface, if it is a very glossy surface, so most of the light is again reflected, semi-diffused, where partially it is reflected and partially it is absorbed. Okay, it is partially reflected and partially it is spread. Okay, and completely diffused, where the light, incident light, is not in the direction of reflection. Okay, so it is completely diffused in other directions. Yes, so diffusion, I think you must have studied in your 10th or 12th, okay, where you study the properties of light, that is diffraction, diffusion, yes, reflection, refraction. Okay, so those properties, so we are trying to use those properties of light or those behavior of light to use in daylighting. Okay, so how we can use those properties for daylighting in buildings. Okay, so this is when we use materials, try to reflect, or we try to allow some portion of light to pass through them. Okay, so these are the basically, you can say, the property or the behavior of light with respect to different surfaces. Yes. So we all know that reflection, yellow paint absorbs blue and it reflects yellow or red and green. Okay. And blue paint absorbs red and yellow, it reflects blue and green. A mixture of both yellow and blue paint will absorb blue, red and yellow and reflects only green color. Okay, so that is why we see green. So this I think you must have studied in color wheel. Yes. By mixing two different colors in various proportions, we try to get different. So these are based on maybe primary colors, you can say. Okay. So illumination is nothing but, again, illumination is nothing but light from a particular source. So to study illumination, we need to study in terms of, again, the color of light. So there are, I think you can, nowadays you can see a lot of artificial lighting getting with different colors. Okay, starting from bright white, LED white, to let's say golden or yellow light. Yes, so where you want to create different kind of ambience. So that is where we use different colors of light. Like restaurants, we try to use yellow lights. Whereas library places or workplaces, we try to use white light, because you need a lot of accuracy or a lot of light for reading or writing or working, where you don't need a lot of stress or strain on the eyes. Yes. Intensity of light. So also indicates different colors of light. Now color rendering. Have you heard this term, color rendering? Yes. Color rendering is what kind of effect the color of light for what kind of effect it creates on a particular object. Yes, so this color rendering technique is actually used in a lot of restaurants and also a lot of places where you go to buy clothes or fabric, like sari, places where they sell saris and these things, where it enhances the color that is reflecting from a particular object. Yes, for different display areas, like a lot of automobile showrooms, they try to use this color rendering. Yes, where different when the light is reflected from that particular object, so it creates a rendering, it creates a different effect. So whatever effect that is creating on a particular object, it is nothing but it is called as color rendering. Like we try to render our, let's say, by pencil rendering, yes, watercolor rendering and this thing. So similarly, by using light, we try to render particular objects. Yes, so this is mainly used in a lot of commercial projects rather than compared to other residential or institutional projects. So we try to use color rendering lot of commercial. I think in most of the commercial projects, they try to use color rendering. Yes, to enhance, let's say, the colors or beauty of a particular object that has to be sold. Okay, so light distribution. So distribution of light in terms of different spaces, like you can consider different spaces, like let's say library or corridor. So what are the different kinds of, you can say, how to diffuse light, where you can get, suppose if you want a darker area so that you want to give some significance to light in certain areas. Yes, I think now if you are working on a meditation center or these things, you will try to make some place dark and make some place very bright, so that you try to see, you try to understand, you try to link it to spirituality. Many people have discussed during design. So that is what distribution of light in different areas. Yes, so it might be functional distribution, or it might be for creating certain aesthetics, or even for certain creating certain ambience. We try to use different types of light distribution. Yes, freedom from glare. What is glare? I think you must have heard glare. So that is also need to be considered. Glare is another one of the major, you can say, problem that is for daylighting. Okay, because usually the sun angle, as we studied altitude angle. So if it is at a lower altitude angle, it is very difficult to control glare. But we also need lot of light. Yes. So we need freedom from glare. So the light has to be diffused, or it has to be reflected, so that there is no glare. Okay. Usually it is try to use diffused or reflected light. So that is the reason why north side windows are considered to be very good, because you get reflected light, you get diffused light, but you don't get the direct sunlight. Okay. So that light also, not just it is not carrying any heat, but it is also preventing from glare or this thing. So that is considered and uniformly distributed to the major part of the day. Okay, so that is why it is considered as very good light or illumination from you can say the north side. Luminance is distribution, again considering various surface qualities together with the lighting of these surfaces. Yes, so different surfaces, or you can say colors, textures also behave different this thing. So we need to study, try to understand in terms of all these aspects, and then we try to get what is a kind of illumination, what is a kind of light, lighting that we are doing in a particular area. Okay, so based on the function of that particular area. Yes, as I said, library will have different requirement of color light or rendering or light distribution, and yeah, of course, freedom from glare or illuminance, luminance. So similarly, if you consider a toy shop, if you consider let's say a supermarket or these things, so then we need to use these particular let's say illumination or lighting in particular areas. Okay, so sources of light is, again, of course, the natural source is considered as skylight, diffused light. So one more light, which is also considered as reflected light. Yes, if you are living next to a, if you having a adjacent building, so if it is, especially if your window is opening towards, let's say, south, or sometimes you can say Yes. If you are building is if you are having a window in the, let's say, north, and if there is a building adjacent to it, so there is a very high chances that you get lot of light that is reflected from that particular building and then enter your building. Okay, so that is, again, it is considered as externally reflected light. Okay, so it can be because of the ground, sometimes because of the ground where the ground is, let's say, if it is paved. Okay, so if it is having some kind of paving, which is again maybe light in color, so like snowfall and these things, then there is lot of light that is reflected. Sometimes if there is a water body, okay, so rivers, and if there is a lot of stagnant water like lake or a water pond or something, so then also there is chances of lot of light getting reflected from that particular this thing. Okay, if you see a lot of these coastal areas, there is also lot of light that is reflected in reflected by the sea. Okay, if you consider the apartments that are located next to the coast, right next to the coast, so they also experience this reflection from the sea. Okay, even if you see Kerala, lot of places, lot of buildings where there is lot of inland water bodies, or I can say backwaters. So if there are so they also face this issue, that is light that is getting reflected from the water body. Okay, so one, it is externally reflected, second is internally reflected. Okay, light can be reflected internally also. Yes, so if you are placing a window right adjacent to a wall, or if it is near the ceiling, then the ceiling reflects light. If it is near the floor, sometimes the floor reflects, or you can say all the different sides of a enclosure, they might reflect based on the property of that particular wall. If it is a white wall, then it reflects more light. If it is a darker wall, or if it is a black wall, let's say, it reflects less light. Even based on different materials, like brick reflects, the reflection from the brick is different from the reflection from, let's say, marble or granite. Yes, or let's say a plastered wall. Okay, and a different colored wall, so they have their own reflection. Okay, so we'll study when we try to understand daylighting. So mainly we'll try to study these three important things: the skylight, the light that is entering into the building, so that might be direct light, externally reflected, internally reflected. Okay, direct sunlight. Okay, so these are the four things actually. So we'll try to make it a mathematical equation, so that we try to get what is the precise value of what is the kind of illuminance or lighting that we are getting in a particular space. Okay, based on the different direction, because north side we are getting different light, south side or west side or east side we are getting different light at different time. Yes, you must have also heard this many people saying morning light is very good because it contains UV rays, which might kill lot of bacteria. Yes, you must have heard this. Yes, so it is actually true. Even a lot of people considered it is good for a healthy, so they try to have sun bath and this thing. So they say most of the doctors also, they try to suggest for a good your body or your skin should absorb a lot of morning, it should be left to exposed to a lot of morning light, because it has got some of the benefits from that particular light. Comparatively, afternoons or evening light is not preferred. So there is again different direction of the light, natural light, and different timing, and even the quality of light is different from morning light to, let's say, evening light or afternoon light. Okay, so that is why we try to study these light behavior, and how we can design buildings, practical application of these buildings, and also try to understand the equation of this in terms of, please keep in mind, these are the four important points, that is diffused or skylight. So diffused light, it can be from the skylight or a window, which is again maybe translucent, or it might be semi-opaque, opaque, or whatever kind of the opening window. It might be having blinds, curtains. Okay, so the light, so that is considered a source of light. Externally reflected, maybe reflected from a building, reflected from a water body, reflected from ground, or any other object that is next to your outside the opening. Okay, so that is reflecting light inside your let's say interior spaces. Yes, internally reflected. What are the kind of walls? What is the location of window? What are the location of different types of you can say we'll try to study and design different elements so that we can reflect the light, and how we can get more light inside, diffused or reflected light inside. Yes, so we always face this problem as architects that light has a limitation that it cannot travel more into the building. Okay, if we are trying to give lot of depth inside the building, so then we face a problem of lighting. Ventilation, it is not a problem because light, air tries to go inside and it tries to escape from a outlet. Yes, but whereas light doesn't behave in that way, it always travels in a straight line, and if there is any object, it will get reflected or diffracted or refracted. Okay, so that is why we try to understand how we can use different elements in buildings so that we can get good illuminance or lighting in different places of inside a building. Okay, so this is again a daylight that is you can see. A is a maybe direct or diffused light because of, let's say, this window, or it can be having a skylight. So this might be again an internally reflected. This is externally reflected light that is coming from a building, externally reflected from a particular building. So this window, if you can see that if your window is towards north and this building is facing south, then there is a chance of a lot of these light gets reflected and enter your building. Okay, so I think this is a very common problem that people face, especially in a lot of dense areas also. So sometimes there is glass which is reflecting a lot of light that is getting glare inside the building. Okay, so this might influence glare also. If there is glass on the top of this, so there might be glare that is entering inside the building. So there might be direct light, reflected light, externally reflected light, or internally reflected because of so there might be reflected from land. So sometimes there is paved area here, so there might be reflected light from the these things. So sometimes if it is a water body, you might see this on let's say on the floor, or you can say on the ceiling, you can see the reflection of the water, the light coming from the reflected after the water. Okay, so there might be again internal reflection which will enhance the quality of light or light inside the building. Okay, so A is skylight, externally reflected, internally reflected, and so on the natural source of light. If let's say there is a skylight or atrium which will get natural light inside the building. Okay.